Okay, so what we're doing here is we're mixing a bottle for one calf, abandoned by the mother. And so we've got 3/4 of a bottle. For the last week, we've been tube feeding him because he wasn't able to take a bottle on his own. So his sister-in-law came down and got us started with the tube feeding process. And the last 2 days, it's kind of gotten a little perkier and looks pretty good. So we're gonna go ahead and try to give it a bottle tonight. 3/4 of a bottle. Did that about that much this morning, and he did real well, so we're gonna try it again. We've got about 10 ounces here of calf starter milk replacer, and that's all there is to it. We've made a little bit of a bigger notch in the end of the tip so that the milk will come out easier and the calf won't have to strain so much to get the milk out. Last Saturday, this little bull that was born was not able to feed from the mama right off the bat, so we brought him home, put him by the fireplace. He was really struggling with a low body temperature, and we built a little corral here in the barn, took him inside and warmed him up by the fireplace, and so this will be home for the next few days until the weather gets a little warmer and he gets a little more strength to him. So here's another little trick for you that the neighbor came up with off the internet, of course. Karo syrup, you can put a little bit on your finger, put it inside the calf's mouth and tickle it a little bit. And once he gets a taste of that Karo syrup, that'll entice him to want to start sucking. And then you can go ahead and coat the tip of the nipple on the bottle a little bit and try that. If he's more interested in the dog than feeding tonight, we'll go ahead and start working that in his mouth. See if he can get the taste of that. Well, he's just tickling the roof of that mouth a little bit, and it don't take much. He's really ready to go. So let's go ahead and try to change that out for that bottle. You may have to pry his mouth open a little bit to start that bottle in there. Go ahead and keep that head down low, keep that bottle up high. That way you don't get any milk into the airway. And he's off to the races. Now we're starting out with 3/4 of a bottle. If he gets that done and he's still acting thirsty, we'll go ahead and increase the dosage and give him a full bottle once in the morning and once at night. Another thing you can do is massage his throat here a little bit as you're feeding. Kind of encourages him to drink. You know, just as I say that, he stops. One of the other things you need to remember is that the colostrum is the mother's first milk that the calf gets, and it's very important that she gets, that this calf gets that colostrum. If you need to, you can run to your local co-op and pick up a bottle of, or a bag of powdered colostrum and get that first dose in that calf so that it has what it needs to get a good start. I think he might be just about done here. We'll try it one more time. Hear that hollow sound, and he is done. Most calves are weaned within 4 to 6 weeks. Some of them that may be born premature will need to take a little extra time, so you'll just have to experiment and see when you can get that calf eating at least 1.5 pounds of calf starter grower grain. Once you got that calf started on the grain and doing really well and drinking water, you can go ahead and wean him. We like to wean them a little slower, kind of cut back on the amount of milk that you would give the calf, and then pretty soon you'll be giving them straight water, and they should do real well. Just kind of have to watch them and see how they're doing. That's it.